Hey, hey homie.
It's your boy Lolo.
And Tanner.
Here with this week's weather.
Announcements.
And sports.
And GPA TV.
Starts right now. You can be my guiding light. Keep me company in the night. That's all I need. All I want is for you to stay a little longer now. With arms around me like a border. Like a green. Vista's Earth Day Festival are looking for volunteers to help at the booths for either three different shifts or all day.
The festival is on April 21st, 2018 from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. at the Alta Vista Gardens.
To sign up or answer any questions, go to the library.
And now for a news story by Savannah Tavares.
Goalkeeper. One of the hardest positions in soccer. Have you ever watched Stefan Fry? He's known for an amazing save. Or maybe Barbara Mitchellin, known for aggressive attitude. To motivated and talented goalkeepers, training their whole life to get where they are today, by pushing themselves to their limits and making sure to work hard. They never underestimate the opponent and always play their best. No one may choose to be goalkeeper, but Caden Tavares did. He wanted to have the responsibility and has the dedication.
I'd say I've been playing soccer for about 8 or 9 years. Goalkeeper is like a completely different like sport in a way, because like I mean you got 10 players that run on the field, like constantly running. And then you have this other player, the 11th player, is the goalkeeper, and he's allowed to use his hands, he has to dive, he has to be very quick, and he's just like different. And I was like, you know what, I kind of want to be that person, I want to be that one person that's different, so.
Is there anybody you look up to?
Yes, there is. Literally, no, I look down to her, that's my sister. Her name is Savannah Tavares. She's been a goalie for how many, I don't know how many years, just a lot of years. But I do look up to her, she's at, and at what level she is. Yeah, she works hard, so I'd say that I would look up to her for her work effort. Ooh, saving my first penalty kick. We were up 1-0, and it was still the first half. And they gave this kid a penalty kick, and I was really mad. And so I like the pressure. So I'm like just staring at the ball. And right when he kicked, I dove left. I see that ball going. And once I hit the ball out, I'm like, oh my goodness, I just saved a penalty kick. Like, it's not very often for a goalie to save a penalty kick. So I'm like, what? Okay, that's weird. And so I'm about to go get it, but I'm like, oh shoot, no, there's a bunch of other people going to get it. I back up. And anyways, the ball ended up being cleared so that we didn't get scored on. But honestly, it was a really good feeling to save that penalty kick, since it's so hard to save them.
Caden Tavares doesn't just hope to play in college. He hopes to make it to the top, pushing himself every day and exceeding his limits. Starting at just a young age, Caden has a dream that one day will come true. This has been Savannah Tavares reporting for GPA TV.
Great job, Savannah.
Yeah, it's kind of crazy to think that our students at Gohomie work so hard. The Knitting and Crafting Club will begin knitting and crafting for the spring holidays.
Come and learn how to knit or crochet Mondays in room 4138 from 3:15 to 4.
Volunteer to help out at the Pause for Books event Thursday, March 1st from 4:30 to 7 at Mission Meadows Elementary.
You will help with the book fair, arts and crafts, the reading corner, science fair projects, and selling food.
For more information, contact Stephanie Pyra at stephaniepyra@vistausd.org.
And now for the weather with Chris.
Hey, Guahomie, I'm Christopher, and I'll be bringing you this week's weather. This week's temperature will range from 43 to 61 degrees, so make sure you guys cop your merch and get this jacket. There is a 10% chance of rain, so this hoodie will come in handy. The Northeast will finally be getting a snowy winter this season, so make sure you guys get your cozy campfire. Tonga was left devastated after Cyclone Gita hit them. Winds reached up to 230 kilometers per hour, and this is the worst storm Tonga has had in the past 60 years. So I hope all of you guys stayed safe. That's all for today's weather, Guahomie. I'm Christopher. Now back to the studio.
And now for sports with Natalie.
Hey, Guahomie, it's Natalie, and I'm bringing you this week's sports section. The Olympics have been a blast so far. The U.S. native Shaun White has killed a halfpipe game, earning the U.S. their 100th gold medal, and Shaun White's third gold. Chloe Kim absolutely destroyed the competition in women's halfpipe, winning another gold medal for the U.S. Michaela Schifrin won a gold in giant slalom skiing. We took a devastating loss against Slovenia in hockey with a score of 3-2. The U.S. women's fought hard in hockey against Canada, but lost 2-1. Next Tuesday and Wednesday will be filled with events. On Tuesday, men's ski halfpipe will occur, so women's bobsled, women's alpine skiing, and women's figure skating. On Wednesday, February 21st, men's freestyle skiing, women's final bobsled, men's slalom, and cross-country skiing will happen. We are currently waiting for the results of the boys' basketball to see where the GPA lands in the playoffs. Be sure to stay tuned to hear more. Be sure to watch our live streams. High school softball will have tryouts on Monday. That's it for today, Guahomie. Now back to the studio.
That's all for today, Guahomie. This has been Tanner
and Lolo
signing out.